for the life of me, I will not ever understand why, for as much as we talk about food plots, as much as we talk about the importance of genetics, as much as we talk about age, on and on, heck, we can go ahead and do an entire show on nothing more than the best apple tree out there. But yet we almost never, whether it's in articles or shows or anything, talk about social stress when it comes to managing our ground. I honestly don't get it. Well, I think I do get it. I think I get the fact that most people don't understand it. Here's the deal. Picture yourself as some overweight kid back in high school walking down the halls, and you're a freshman. And you've got all these juniors and seniors giving you merciless grief. They're picking on you. They're hitting the books out of your hands. When I was a kid, and I'm not suggesting anybody does this, but when I was a kid, you got beat up. You know, think about if you were ever in those types of situations or know somebody who has been, think about how stressful that is. There was all these studies when I was back in high school and college that had come out about how horrifically unhealthy stress is for humans, for us, how it leads to elevated risks of heart attacks, strokes, all sorts of junk. Don't you think it's the same in the whitetail community? Especially now, you have to understand that every chunk of dirt out there can hold X number of deer healthily. At a healthy level. That means that the habitat can go ahead and produce enough food, all this type of stuff. There are plenty of exceptions to what I'm about to say, but right now in the deer management world, for whatever reason, overpopulation tends to be the biggest issue. Don't get me wrong, there's pockets in the state of New York, there's pockets in central and northern Minnesota, northern Wisconsin, where deer numbers are still low, but so many places they're high. These deer are competing over food, bedding, water, all this stuff. The higher the deer numbers, the higher the competition. Over limited resources, the more social stress these whitetails endure. If you ever really want to see it play out, go to an area that is just disgustingly overpopulated for what the habitat can supply. And you watch, and I'll bet you're going to see, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, out start coming the does. And then out start coming more, and the ones that were on that limited food source just got kicked off. And out comes some more, and the ones who just kicked off the first ones kicked off the second, and so on and so on and so on. What you're actually seeing is you're seeing social stress on steroids play out in the real world. The more submissive family groups have to go to the food source early, because otherwise they're not gonna get any. They're gonna be driven off. So it ends up creating a snowball where these deer have to get more and more and more aggressive simply to go ahead and survive. Social stress is a huge deal when it comes to management. If we want to, and this is not for everybody, but for those who want to strive to grow the biggest, healthiest deer out there, you have to understand that social stress is a big deal. And just a real quick way of trying to address it, it's more of a mindset. Rather than create that one food source on that 80 acres to draw all those deer, creating two is going to go ahead and help disperse that social stress. Creating three will help disperse it even more. Four will take it even further. Okay, it's up to each of us to find that balance, but really think about it. There are huge hunting advantages to having that one centralized food source, that one centralized bedding area, that one centralized water source. That's great for hunting, but it's horrible for management because it puts that stress level on those whitetails on steroids. And that impacts antler development, it impacts body growth, it impacts absolutely everything we're striving to max. Social stress is really an extremely important yet hardly ever discussed aspect of whitetail management. No, this type of stuff is not for everybody. Just go out there and hunt if that's what you want to do, and more power to you. But if you want to get the most out of your whitetails on that ground. And your habitat, what you're going to strive to do is minimize social stress. You minimize social stress and it pays off in fawn recruitment, it pays off on body weights and antler size. Social stress is a dang big deal.